So I know that date night is an issue for people, and especially now with the virus going around, it's a little bit more challenging, but they're still going out. You know, people are going on walks and they're doing other things. They're going for drives, they're doing certain things, and it's gonna hopefully be more and more. But I wanted to mention, I got an email from somebody recently who said, you know, when I go out with my husband, I feel like it's a big chore for him and he's not really into it. And I feel like every time I'm gonna pull teeth, let's go on date night, let's go to, you know, and I feel like I'm forcing him. So how do I get around this? So here's the rule. There's three things. Number one, make it totally fun for him. So that means don't bring up like old things he did before that you're mad at him about. Don't bring up too stressful things. Look, there's times to have conversations, deep conversations, that needs to happen. But on a date night, maybe that's not the time to do it. You know your husband best, but want to keep it light, want to not blame him. And the second thing is not blame him for things he's doing and making him feel bad. Anytime you're thinking, boy, is what's coming out of my mouth going to make him so he doesn't want to go on a date night again? If that's the case, don't say it. Now you might say, well, Leah, I've got to be myself. What, do you want me to walk on eggshells? You want me to, you don't cut off your nose to spite your face. Get the date nights going, get them steady. And then if they're so enjoyable, he'll want to go on them more. And then you can slip a little, maybe one little thing, you know, but pick your battles. This is not the time to make this like, oh, now I've got his undivided attention. I'm going to let him have it. Not good strategy. And the third thing on date night is to, if you can come in with a clean slate and not like batter him with any of the stuff that's going on in your mind. Like sometimes people don't get a date night and then they just use it as a complete complaint session. I've got him there, he's sitting there, he can't go anywhere, let me just throw all my complaints at him. If you do that, it's not gonna be something he's gonna look forward to. So those are some little tips about it or whatever. Again, should he be doing the same thing to you? Yes, he is. Waiting for him to be like the perfect husband ain't gonna happen. Better you just be your best self, giving yourself the best odds of having the happiest, wonderful time with your husband, and then things will flow. Okay, is it annoying you're the one to start? Maybe, I get that. Does it work? Guaranteed. This is Leah Richheimer for the Ladies Talk Show. We'll see you next time.